Thank you so much, Professor Bajit Sir. Indeed, Muslim population in India plays a great role in shaping the foreign policy of Indo-Iran relations. And it is the need of oil's requirement which forms 10% of India's oil requirement, which is acquired from Iran. These things also play a great important role in framing the foreign policy of Indian government. And US also plays a very determined role in India and US Iran relations. Thank you so much, Baljeet Sir. With this, now I benignly request Dr. Jafar Ali Khan to present his paper. Dr. Jafar Ali Khan did his PhD in West Asian Studies from Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi, and currently he is an associate professor at Government Degree College, Kargil. Dr. Jafar Ali Khan.
Respected speakers, distinguished guests, and my dear friends. The title of my paper is Iranian Students in India, a Sociological Study. This is an sociological and empirical study based on research survey, which was last year submitted to Jawaharlal Nehru University for my PhD thesis. This study is an attempt to investigate the complex problem of adjustment and adaptability of Iranian students to a new environment like India. The study focuses on the following research questions. The first is the reasons for Iranian students' choice of India as an educational destination. And the second is to assess the perception of Iranian students regarding Indian academic milieu, standard, and overall educational environment. And the third one is to analyze the problem of personal and social adjustment of Iranian students in India. And finally, to investigate regarding Iranian students' future plans and job prospects after completing their education in India. Before going into detail, I will give the brief review of my research methodology. The methodology of my research can be explained by two distinct ways. The first phase consists of the survey of available literature, which was available earlier, and the second phase consisting of exploring the area of study through the intensive interaction with the Iranian students in India. As part of the process, I spent considerable time in the company of Iranian students by frequently visiting them in the different universities of Delhi. Apart from universities, such interactions were also available, made by the platforms where possible to meet with the Iranian students. Such platforms include Iranian Culture House in Delhi and the functions and activities organized by the Iranian students on the regular basis in different universities. Yeah, I also approached some group of Iranian students for some sort of group discussions to find out if they were facing any problem in India. Since such interactions were meant to be spontaneous and informal, notes were not to be taken soon possible, but after the conclusion of such meetings, the regular notes were taken place. On the basis of the plenary interview with individual students, group discussions, and insight developed from the related studies, the interview schedule was prepared for the purpose of the pilot study. After the pilot study, it was decided to suitable approach would be taken to obtain relevant data. The research design of the study was to personally interview around 200 Iranian students with the help of the interview schedule. An attempt was made to have a representative sample in terms of gender and academic disciplines. The Iranian students were spread all over the country. Therefore, due to practical limitations of the available natural, it was not possible to cover all of them. So it was decided that Delhi, Pune, and Bangalore, where the majority of Iranian students reside. It was possible to get the list of complete Iranian students who are studying in India. Therefore, the researcher approached organizations including Association of Indian Universities, Ministry of HRD, foreign student advisor bodies of the respective universities for the list of Iranian students. For the analysis of data collection, information and insights gained through personal observation are also served a crucial tool. The field work of my study almost took 2 years to get completed. The questions containing in the interview schedules were related to Iranian students' socio-economic background, their coming to India, academic profile, financial and emotional problems, social lack in India, and finally their future after completing their degrees in India. I faced several difficulties during my field work, which I'd like to mention here. First was the most important was to get appointment with the researcher. It was very difficult to get appointment with them because the schedule was almost take half an hour to get completed. And the students get impatient and they make some intelligent excuses to not giving the interview. And the second one is that they would look suspicious and doubt about the researcher. Either they thought I am from the Ministry of HID or from some agencies, intelligent agencies. Ministry of HID and some Iranian embassy, they were a little bit suspicious. After this, I would like to give my tale of this study. The first is India is an educational destination for Iranian students. Traditionally, India has always led the participant of foreign students and scholars. During the first 8th century, Indian centers of learning such as Nalanda, Takshila and Vikramshila attracted students from distant countries like China and Korea. In this era of globalization, India is fast emerging as a popular destination for foreign students. The quality of education in India, particularly in the disciplines of science, technology, mathematics, as well as Indological subjects, has been attracted foreign students to Indian universities from all over the world. International students from developing countries come for higher education in India in every disciplines ranging from humanities, social science, technology, agriculture, medicine, management studies, etc. Students from developing countries consist about 95% of international students. Majority of foreign students who come to India from African regions such as Sudan, Ethiopia, Kenya, Mauritius, etc. During the academic year of 2000 and 2001, 584 Kenyan students, 301 Sudanese students were admitted to Indian universities and colleges. The total number of students from West Asian region during the academic year of 2001 was 1,000, and during the 2007 and 2008 academic year, it was 8,000. The students from developing countries come to India largely from the program pertaining to the Indian studies and performing arts. Development. Such students include Government of India scholars, self-financed students, etc. The number of such students, however, quite small. The international student population in India is not equally distributed in terms of region of the country or academic disciplines. Students prefer the western and southern part of India. During 2000 and 2001, where some around 5,000 students were studying near Maharashtra at 28%. International students prefer to join educational institutions located in and among the, around the metropolitan cities like Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Bangalore, etc. Pune is the preferred destination for foreign students. Information related to the number of international students studying in India given by different agencies is varied. So in many cases, only the approximation. We do not have the precise data about the total number of Iranian students in India. According to Association of Indian Universities, the total population of Iranian students in India is around 5 to 6,000. And some Iranian students claim that it's 10,000 to 15,000. So there are studying in different universities in India. Majority of the students studying in Pune, Mysore, Bangalore, Aligarh, Chandigarh, and Delhi. These students are engaged in every discipline from humanities, social science, technology, medicine, management studies, and agriculture. Now there are a number of reasons for Iranian students coming to India in such large numbers. During the survey, it was found that majority of Iranian students prefer India as an educational destination for various reasons. The first is cultural similarities between India and Iran and shared culture between the two countries. The second one is the educational and maintenance cost is low in India as compared to Western countries. And the third one is difficulties to get admission in Iranian universities. And the fourth is shortages of universities in Iran. And the fifth one is to easier to get admission in Indian universities as compared to the Western countries, because they do not have to clear TOEFL or GRE in India. And the sixth one is less distance between Tehran and Mumbai. And the last, and the seventh one, the quality of education in India is good in some courses. And the final one is English is the main source of attraction to the Indian university. When the Iranian students were asked to identify two most important reasons for coming to India, 60% of them mentioned that due to low cost, such as accommodation and cost as compared to Western countries, is their primary reason. 70% of the respondents mentioned that the tough entrance examination for getting admission in Indian universities is their primary reason, as they have to clear the preliminary exam, which is known as the CONCOR. Apart from these two reasons, the cultural reason was considered to be more important by the majority of Iranian students. For 30% of the students said the cultural similarities between India and Iran and the historical ties between the two countries played an important role for coming to India. During the survey, some students mentioned that due to cultural similarities, they felt comfortable in India. For example, one student mentioned that it is very easy to make friendship with Indians due to some similarities between both of them. On the other hand, the United States and other Western countries, they found huge cultural differences. Some Iranian students come to India with their families, and they were also sending their children to the Indian schools. Some students mentioned that less distance between Tehran and Mumbai also influenced their decision to opt for India instead of Western countries. A majority of Iranian students in India are from urban areas of Iran, such as Tehran, Tabriz, and Mashhad. Most of the Iranian students are self-financed, and very few of them are getting scholarship. Those students who are getting fellowship are enrolled in higher programs such as Masters and PhD. The reasons for not getting the fellowship to the students mentioned that the very high competition and very few sources are available. The main concentration of Iranian students are in Pune, as I mentioned, Chandigarh, Delhi and Mysore. We can divide the Iranian students coming to India in three categories. First is the students between the age group of 19 to 24. Coming for just passing 12th class, and they face lots of problems in India for few months to adjust. And the second is between age of 24 to 30, come for their master degree programs and some professional courses like MBA, MCM and other categories of students. Have little bit of English and comfortable their course in India. Third group is above 30 and coming for the doctorate degree from India. Majority of them are getting fellowship in India, as they were holding some positions in Iran, like university teacher, etc. The socio-economic background of the Iranian students, they are from diverse social and economic background. Majority of the Iranian students belong to urban areas, as I already mentioned. The age group of Iranian students, the between 18 to 45 years. Oldest respondent I met was 45-year-old, and he was doing his PhD from Pune University. Earlier he holds some position in Iranian Tehran University, acted as an assistant professor there. As I mentioned earlier, some Iranian students choose India as an educational destination because of low maintenance cost. This was the reason given by the majority of Iranian students. Interestingly, some students use India as a stepping stone, ultimately go to United States or other Western countries, because after completing their education in India, it is easier to go to the United States and other Western countries. Student activities which the Iranian students do in India, as far as their activities are concerned, Iranian students have established their own student unions in India, particularly in Pune. They conduct annual election for their student union. Their student union is responsible for arranging accommodation for the new students and addresses their admission problems in college and universities. The student union organizes cultural programs such as Nowruz, Muharram, and Ali Day on such occasions. The student union in Pune organizes Iranian Film Festival every year. Iranian students participate in several programs organized by international students in the university. On their activities, it is interesting to mention that one comment One respondent said that we Iranians in Pune celebrate all the festivals somehow together. And you can find all Iranians have Facebook and Orkut profile on internet. It is the best way to talk to each other in India. Another female student mentioned that through the cultural association in India, we can propagate Iranian culture to the world. It helps the students to stay on one platform. Now, quickly on the educational problem faced by Iranian students in India. During the survey, it was observed that majority of Iranian students with a problem with English. They cannot speak proper English and it becomes a major problem to them. To overcome this problem, large number of Iranian students either enroll in English remedial courses or provided by the university or independently they join some private institutions to improve their English. Academic difficulties of Iranian students are broadly divided into four parts. First relates to the understanding of lectures in the class. Second is the problem of participation in the seminars and discussions. And the third is the problem they face in the expressing them orally. And finally, the fourth one is regarding the understanding of texts, books and journals which they had to read mostly in English. After arriving in India, the students found it's not very easy to get admission in their choice of program. And the program with the English is very important in Indian universities. In spite of... Yes?
Yes, you can confine to my subject matter, please.
Subject?
India-Iran relation.
This is the Indo-Iran relation.
You are discussing the student from
here. This is the student relation between India and Iran. When the Iranian students are coming to India, they got some relationships. But after arriving in India, one question related to such issues raised by is the, are you satisfied with the academic progress in India? The response to this question was divided into four parts. It's the great, moderate, slight, and not a lot. Out of 200 of Iranian students, around 70 of them said we are totally satisfied with the academic progress in India. And 75 of them said we are slightly not satisfied with the academic progress in India. Lastly, I'll come to the socio-cultural adjustment of Iranian students in India. After arriving in India, the first problem faced by the student is to finding a suitable accommodation to live. At this time, when he pressed the problem of adjustment on many sides, social, academic, food, weather, and physical surroundings, the difficulties of accommodation increased to his strength considerably. In the interview, the students were asked if they had any difficulties in connection with their accommodation. Around 70% of them answered yes, they have some difficulties during their accommodation. Finally, I'll give you some major findings of my study. The Iranian students studying in India are mostly come from upper middle class. The second, the Iranian students prefer India as an educational destination because of moderate fee structure compared to the Western countries. Third, during the initial stays in India, the Iranian students often face language difficulties in terms of medium of instruction and language of day-to-day communication. And finally, the adjustment and attitude of Iranian students towards India and Iran get some change with their length of stay in India. Thank you. Thank you.